Hello and welcome to this week's telly show. A telly show with a difference. I know what you're thinking, sat there at home. What's that idiot doing wearing sunglasses in October? Well, this idiot is in Cannes for Cannes TV Festival, otherwise known as MIPCON, with the sole aim of trying to sell this TV show to TV executives from around the world. So this week, we'll be covering two different subjects, that being sales and hustling, and the wonderful world of television, which we're currently at the centre of. So, can I sell my TV show? Shia LaBeouf, any words of wisdom?
Do it! Just do it! Don't let your dreams be dreams. Yesterday, you said tomorrow. So just do it! Make your dreams come true! Just do it! Some people dream of success while you're gonna wake up and work hard at it. Nothing is impossible. You should get to the point where anyone else would quit, and you're not gonna stop there. No, what are you waiting for? Do it!
What?
Just do it! Yes, you can! Just do it! If you're tired of starting over, stop giving up.
Never gonna give you up.
I mean, selling can't be that hard. You want a loom band, right?
You're not going to sell anything sitting there not shouting.
Yeah, well, I'm going to keep on shouting until we buy one.
Well, you got to shout then.
Anyone want my loom band? For goodness sake! I'm getting bored!
Why the long face?
No one buying one because it's
Fancy a night out without buying a drink? Maybe try this.
Alex is out for drinks in a seaside bar, but he's not planning to spend his own money.
All right, OK, look, straightforward challenge. The winner is the person who can open this bottle, but can't use a bottle opener.
I think the teeth.
You look as if you could do it with your teeth, but don't, please.
No, honestly.
No, you can't use your teeth. No body parts involved, I'm afraid.
No.
Eye sockets or...
Nose.
Nose. The only thing you have is you've got to use this piece of paper. This is going to be our bottle opener.
Hold on.
You have to draw
a lollipop.
There you go. That's this is our opener. So you've got to use this piece of paper to get this bottle open.
Can you fold it?
You can fold it if you like.
It does make the paper stronger, doesn't it?
Yeah.
But just to make it strong enough to open up the bowl.
Can I touch the bottle? Yeah. If it isn't, we'll get one that you're happy with. You happy with that one?
Yeah, I'm happy with that one.
If I do it, will you at least pay for the beer and a couple of more? Shall I do it?
Yeah.
Yes, but how?
How is he going to fold it?
It costs a beer to find out.
Maybe he's going to hit us with a paper and then go and get it.
Loop it around and pull it up.
Oh, he's going to do it like the clipper.
No!
Why didn't you think of that earlier? Oh my goodness.
It's like doing the clippers.
Oh.
Thank you very much.
Alex folded the paper in half lengthways, then again and again.
Are you lost in London? Never mind. Give this a go.
Hello. The Knowledge is a premium rate telephone helpline, which uses licensed London taxi drivers to provide directions and live navigation to people who are lost in London. Everyone knows that When you want to know the time, you ask a policeman. And if you want to know where things are in London, you ask a cab driver. And that's because of the amazing, unique, world-famous knowledge that they have of the city. So how does it work? Well, we have created a virtual call centre that uses London cab drivers working from home. The caller pays for this through its telephone bill. And the calls are charged at £1 a minute using a BT landline. There's also the ability to cross-sell. We can refer people to hotels and restaurants and get commission on that sort of arrangement. So, to sum up, we think we've got a unique product. We think there's a large market for it. We think there's proven demand, and it's highly scalable. And underpinned by this unusual business model, highly profitable. But don't take my word for it. I have a telephone with me if any of you would like to try the service and see for yourself.
I think we better try the service first.
Okay.
So, talk me through it. What do I do?
£1 a minute from a landline. Calls from mobile phones may cost more. You're now being connected to a licensed London taxi driver. Please have a safe journey. Please wait. Please wait.
How much a minute?
Pound a minute.
Thank you for holding. Our agents are still helping other lost people at the moment, but we're trying to get to you as soon as possible.
We'll see where the income's coming
from. If you can't continue to hold, press 2 if you would like us to text you when an agent becomes available.
This is a disastrous start for Gerard. His crucial demo is failing, and telecoms magnate Peter Jones is not impressed.
Peter, you might want to hang up and try again.
Hang up and try again?
Well, it depends. I don't know if you want to wait on the call, but...
We are still trying.
OK. So, Gerard, it's not a good start, really.
OK, so I've sort of been inspired by those clips, but it's clear it's not going to be easy selling my TV show. But, as Shia says, I just got to do it! Let's sell. Hello, I'm Guy Lloyd, and I'm at Cannes TV Festival, otherwise known as MIPCON. I'm here for 3 reasons. 1, top up my tan. 2, eat bread. 3, sell a TV show. I'm going in. Right, this is the hub of MIPCON. This is where a lot of it happens, so there's a lot of people going in and out, so we're going to grab some people milling around. And then probably go inside and try and sell this TV show. Excuse me, sir, have you got a minute? No? Have you got a second?
No.
You have, you liar. Would you buy my TV show?
What's your TV show?
It's called The Guy Lloyd Telly Show. Would you buy my TV show?
No, I'm from Argentina.
That's fine. I'm huge in Argentina.
Sorry, what?
Yeah, what's your show about you trying to sell?
Well, thanks for asking.
Yeah. Thanks for asking. Big Northern Act, big giveaway. Thanks for asking. What, you'll try to sell then, love? In Cannes. It's lovely here, isn't it?
This is my pitch. It's 22 minutes, and I choose 2 subjects affecting your life and our lives, everybody's lives, and I go out and I ask people about that subject.
Oh, so it's topical local people. News?
No, it's more about life. It's not time-specific, or it's not really Brighton-specific.
Oh, that's why you're here to sell it at MIP.
Yeah.
Ooh, have you had any luck?
Not at all.
And we back it up with YouTube clips and funny monologues to camera.
Yeah. I think there's 2 shows you can always sell there. Anything about Hitler and Sharks.
Right.
5 euros?
No. No. Sorry.
2?
No.
No. So you're interested?
Yes.
Where are you from?
New York.
New York. Have you got a card?
I do.
We got a business card.
Yes, I buy it.
He's going to buy the TV show. How much will you give me for the TV show?
A lot.
Okay, day 1 at MIPCON in Cannes, and I think it's been a fairly successful day. I came here to sell my TV show. One guy did make me an offer, but he sells headphones for a living, so I doubt he's got any money. However, I have got some very interesting business cards. So we're going back to the hotel now. I'm going to email those people on those business cards, my show, and hopefully we can strike up possibly a meeting tomorrow and possibly a sale. It's been a fairly good first day here in Cannes. We'll see you tomorrow. TV is a powerful thing. Most of us remember when these events happened.
Welcome back. They say that all-seeing eye of the television camera never blinks and that it catches everything. In fact, some of the biggest stories in the world have played out on our TV sets.
But which moments have been the most memorable? Mina Ri finds out what made the cut and the moments that were surprisingly left off the list.
One small step for man.
The lunar landing marked a pivotal moment for the human race.
I didn't go to sleep for 24 hours.
While television sets around the world may have been tuned into Apollo 11, it didn't make the cut into TV's top 20 most memorable moments. That is, according to a recent survey by Nielsen Television Research Company and Sony Electronics. The findings showed news-oriented items cross generations when resonating with viewers.
What strikes me most about this list is not so much what's on it, but what's not on it. There's no final episodes of sitcoms or dramas. There's no celebrity meltdowns. So what that shows me is the events that resonate most with people are the ones that really shape our world.
There's one event that draws in more viewers than any other every year. You probably guessed, it's the Super Bowl. And while it may be a magnet to millions of viewers at the time, sporting events don't seem to leave a lasting impression. Now, Sony was interested in the study for clues on consumer interest in their behavior, and they found that despite all of our cutting-edge technology, that the television is still the grandmother or granddaddy of all social devices. This is still what people go towards when big events happen.
TV can also deliver some brilliantly awkward moments.
The top 10 awkward moments in live TV history. Number 10, Martin Short's late wife, The Today Show.
But you're still, like, in love.
Madly in love.
In 2012, Martin Short dropped by The Today Show to promote Madagascar 3. Things started cheerfully as funny man Short discussed his family with Kathy Lee Gifford and Hoda Kotb. The interview suffered great turbulence, however, when Kathy Lee asked Short about his enduring marriage to Nancy Dolman.
And he and Nancy have gotten one of the greatest marriages of anybody in show business. How many years now for you guys?
We married 36 years.
Apparently, Kathy Lee didn't get the memo that Nancy had passed away from ovarian cancer 2 years earlier.
Okay, guys, before we go on, Martin just told me as he was leaving, he said, Kathy, you probably didn't know, but his beautiful, precious wife, Nancy, did pass away.
Short was courteous enough not to tell Kathy Lee about his wife's departure on air. But behind his smile, we can clearly see the poor guy's grief. Number 9, Tom Hanks drops the F-bomb, Good Morning America. Tom Hanks is such a clean-cut everyman that it's actually hard to imagine him casually swearing. But the truth is, every person occasionally lets an F-bomb slip.
I want people to buy me book and f***ing book.
Number 8, Geraldo finds nothing in Al Capone's vault, the mystery of Al Capone's vaults.
What secrets lie hidden inside Al Capone's vaults? Find out when we open it on live television.
Al Capone was one of the most notorious and iconic gangsters in American history. When Geraldo Rivera hosted a live special unveiling the contents of Capone's secret vault in 1986, approximately 30 million people tuned in to see what treasures awaited. In the ultimate anti-climax, Rivera and his crew found exactly nothing.
I'm disappointed about that, as I'm sure you are. This is one time in my life that a pot of gold would have been a lot more fun than chasing the rainbows.
Number 7, the Balloon Boy interview, Larry King Live.
Millions watched on live television as a weather balloon flew high over the skies of the state. Heaney reported his 6-year-old may have been inside.
The Balloon Boy hoax took America by storm for about 5 seconds in 2009, when Richard and Mayumi Heaney allegedly released a gas balloon that, unbeknownst to them, had their son Falcon inside. Later that day, the 6-year-old boy was found hiding in his house. When Wolf Blitzer interviewed the family, Falcon revealed that his parents had cooked up this entire ruse as a publicity stunt.
We did this for a show.
Number 6, Samuel L. Jackson or Lawrence Fishburne, KTLA Morning News. When you're an entertainment journalist, though, you need to get all the facts straight, especially when you're doing live TV. In this 2014 KTLA Morning News interview, Sam Rubin accidentally confuses Sam Jackson with fellow African-American actor Lawrence Fishburne.
You're as crazy as the people on Twitter.
Right.
I'm not Lawrence Fishburne.
That's my fault. Oh, I know that. That was my fault. My mistake.
Number 5. Kanye West crashes Taylor Swift's VMA speech, the MTV Video Music Awards.
Yo, Taylor, I'm really happy for you. I'm gonna let you finish.
Kanye's had his fair share of uncomfortable TV appearances, like that time he dissed George W. Bush on a Hurricane Katrina telethon.
George Bush doesn't care about black people.
But the rapper broke new ground for jackassery at the 2009 VMAs, when Taylor Swift won the award for Best Female Video. Unable to fathom the idea that Beyoncé's Single Ladies didn't win. Kanye jumped on stage, stole Swift's mic, and proclaimed that his beloved Beyoncé was the true victor.
But Beyoncé had one of the best videos of all time.
Kanye was subsequently booed off stage and removed from the ceremony. Number 4, Sinead O'Connor tears up the Pope's photo, Saturday Night Live.
We have confidence.
Seeing how Saturday Night Live is, well, live, the late-night variety show has inevitably produced a few controversial unscripted moments. The program hit a particularly rocky speed bump in 1992 when Sinead O'Connor appeared as the musical guest.
Nothing compares to you.
Protesting sexual abuse in the Catholic Church, O'Connor sang Bob Marley's War a cappella and held up a photo of Pope John Paul II. Number 3. The Ashley Simpson lip-syncing incident, Saturday Night Live. In 2004, Ashley Simpson was booked as SNL's musical guest. Although Simpson's Pieces of Me went off without a hitch, things got muddled with her second song. Instead of singing Autobiography as planned, the vocals for Pieces of Me started to play again before Simpson even opened her mouth.
On a Monday, I'm waiting.
Caught lip-syncing, Simpson tried to salvage the performance with an awkward dance, then shamefully walked off stage. Number 2, F*** It, I Quit, the Anchorage 11 KTVA News.
I sat and I thought out loud.
Anybody who's lost passion for their work has likely fantasized about quitting in a blaze of glory. Speaking of blazes, Charlo Green got to live the dream when she quit her job as a reporter for KTVA News. After reporting on the Anchorage, Alaska medical marijuana organization, the Alaska Cannabis Club, Green revealed herself as its owner. Rather than giving her bosses 2 weeks' notice, she came out and said exactly what was on her mind.
And as for this job, well, not that I have a choice, but I quit.
Number 1. Janet Jackson's wardrobe malfunction, Super Bowl 38. The final score of Super Bowl 38 was an afterthought. Hell, we bet you don't even remember who played. All anyone recalls is the event's legendary halftime show. Towards the song's conclusion, Timberlake reached out and tore off a piece of Jackson's clothing, exposing her right breast. Almost 10 years later, the incident, now known as Nipplegate, is still the defining wardrobe malfunction. Do you agree with our list?
The type is all off, sorry, but I'll just wing this.
Right, I'm still on a mission to sell my TV show. Let's go back out there and just do it! We're outside the Carlton Hotel, just behind me, where there's a party going on. So we're going to go in there and try and sell the show again. Why not? Let's do it. Will you buy my TV show?
What's it about?
It's about life. Right, it's serious. It's serious. It's TV. This is TV. We're from England.
Oh, gosh.
Yeah, I'm so sorry.
It sounds good. Go ahead.
He likes it. This is good. It's a half an hour show about life.
Sounds boring.
It's not working out here. It's not working out. Reaching into his pocket, and there is the 6th business card for today. Buy it.
No.
Buy it now.
Why?
Give me some money.
Why? No.
Because that's why we're here.
Good luck.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you. I'll call you tomorrow. Cheers, man.
That was kind of outside of the box.
She's drunk. She's drunk. There's no deal happening here. What's your name, sir?
Adam Hamm.
Adam Ant.
Adam Ham.
Adam Ham, okay. Yeah. And you organized this party?
A part of it.
A part? Which part?
The fun part.
So how much money does one spend on parties like this?
At least $500,000.
Half a million?
Yeah.
Wow. That's incredible.
It's a lot.
There's one thing missing. There wasn't, for me, there wasn't enough sausage rolls. And, you know, cheese and pineapple on sticks? None of that. Yeah, but even with cheese and pineapple, I mean, you can just cut that, you know, into little chunks, can't you? It's not.
It's really technical and it's really complex.
My mum did it for like 20 years and she was not technical. She was drunk most of the time.
Yes.
Well, that's it from this week's telly show. We came to Cannes for 4 days. We didn't sell the TV show, but we've made some good contacts. And who knows what could happen from here. It's all about the hustle. We're going to come back next year, hopefully, and sell the bugger. Meanwhile, I'll see you back here in this slot for more nonsense this time next week.